Good morning. Good morning, everyone. It is Anne. It is Wednesday morning, and here we are for our Silver Sneakers workout. Make sure you leave a comment if you're watching the video, even if you're watching it later, just because we get credit for you watching it. So let's go ahead and start by marching. We'll get warmed up here. Hope everyone is doing well. Make sure we're swinging our arms here to get all the blood pumping. And a little twist to warm our backs up. And some nice big arm circles. If that's too much for your shoulders, take your hands to the top of your shoulder and we'll be right here. We've got about 45 minutes of strength here today and march. Total body, seated or standing is an option. If you have your weights and your band, go ahead and grab them. Little low impact jumping jack. Of course, you are welcome to do a regular jumping jack if you'd like. You're always allowed to make it harder if you want. I'll never judge you for that. Just as long as we're safe, right? Of course, turn on your music if you can and march. Then we'll reach to the edges. Just getting a nice stretch through our side here, getting warmed up. Couple more. And march. We're going to take our hamstring curl here, kicking your heel up to your butt. It's warming up the back of the leg here. If you want to throw a little punch in there, you can do that too. March. Then we're going to take our feet hip distance. We're sitting back into a little squat. So just a tiny one, just the top half, just to get your glutes and your quads going. Keeping your core tight. Really sitting your hips back. If you looked at yourself from the side, you'd want to be sure that your knees aren't coming out over your toes. So keeping your weight in your heels, sitting the butt back, pressing the hips forward, squeezing the glutes at the top. And march. March on over to your chair and grab your ball. Hopefully you have your water near you too. We want to make sure we're staying hydrated. I'm going to scoot up to you a little bit. We're going to start right here, just pressing the ball between our palms, holding a little pause right there. So you want to feel this through your chest and in your arms. Of course, your core is nice and tight. pause. Don't forget the pause. That's where the magic happens. Good. And then put that ball between the knees, right above the knees, actually. And we're going to squeeze in the center here. Give it a little pause before you release again. It's that little isometric hold where the magic happens. Don't worry about popping the ball. They're pretty sturdy. Really give it a squeeze like you mean it. Squats first. So we keep the ball there just because it helps to keep your knees from knocking in on your squat. So we'll stand up and you can either tap your butt and just tap the bench or the chair. I'll show you from the side. It looks like this. You're just reaching your butt back, not sitting all the way down, or you can sit all the way down and stand all the way up. You're still going to be building those quad and glute muscles. Tap it back. If you want a little extra, double tap at the bottom. Only if your form is good, only if it feels right. Nicely done. Always listening to our body first, right? We don't want to do anything that's going to give us that actual setback. You know, we're trying to progress here. Not sit back. All right, couple more. And rest. Then right back to where we started, pressing in with our palms. You can do this seated or standing, up to you. You pick. Some exciting news. On Tuesday, I'm going to go get my knee injected. So you know you're getting old when you're excited about getting your knee injected. I'm just hoping it makes me feel better. They're injecting it with, I think it's hyaluronic acid. It's from the rooster's comb. I don't know if the comb is that thing or this thing, but it's from that. And then above the knees, and we're squeezing here. Give it a little pause in the middle. Squats. You know your options. You can just give it a little tap, or you can sit all the way down. That double tap is an option as well. Just get a little bit more bang for your buck. Nice. One more round of these, okay? Pressing together, squeezing in here. Good job. Do one more. Hold and squeeze, 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 squeeze. And release. Good. Between the knees. Squeezing in. Pausing in the center. Job. Feel this in your inner thighs, but we're also keeping our core nice and tight, right? Let's do just a couple more. And then on the last one, hold and squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Squeeze it like you mean it. If you're trying to crush a watermelon. Release. Now we have our squats, or you're sitting down and standing up, whatever's working best for you today. Double tap if you want it. Good job. Make sure you're really sitting your hips back and then pressing them forward and squeezing the buns at the top. Almost there. And rest. Go ahead and take your ball and ditch it. Then grab yourself a sip of water. And then grab your band. We're going to take our wrists through. And here are your options. You're going to give yourself about shoulder width distance between. And if you're seated, you're going to pretend like you're paddling a kayak. Now, if you're comfortable with standing, you're going to be paddling a stand-up paddleboard. Getting your legs involved if you want. But nice big scoops here, really keeping your core tight. So again, you're sitting your hips back. Good job. Paddle, paddle. Then we've got our bands pressing out for our abductors. When we were squeezing the ball, that was for the inside of our thighs. This is for the outside. So make sure you have some slack between your feet. And then you have choices. If you're seated, it's here. Just pressing out one side at a time. If you're standing, you can take a little step from side to side like so. Or balance on one foot. Press out with the other. Totally up to you, whatever feels best for you today. It's a really good challenge for your balance if you just use the one foot at a time, but if you feel like you're gonna fall, not worth it. Good. Keep your core tight. And one more, good. And then you can either keep both feet on the band there or take one off. We've got a bicep curl here. We're just slow and controlled on the way up, slow and controlled on the way down. Giving it a little pause there at the top. Good. You want to get a nice full range of motion, so bringing it all the way up and then slowly coming all the way down. Very nice. cannot read anything on that iPad. I'm like, who's there? I don't know. Oh well. Probably better if I don't know, if I'm just in here talking to myself. Let's do one more of these. Pause at the top, slowly down. Good. And then back to our paddling out, either in your kayak or on your stand-up paddleboard, whatever's working for you, shoulder width, and let's go. Good job, some tension on that band. Your arms are nice and straight. And rest. Good job. Back to our abductors, pressing out. Get ready, go. Rest. Then we have our bicep curls here. Slow and controlled. Good. Make sure that you're keeping your shoulders back. So you don't want to be here. You want to be here. Very nice. Do one more and rest. Well done. We have one more round. Starting first with our paddling out. Ready? Go. Seated or standing, getting a nice range of motion, keeping your core tight to protect your back. There. And rest. And we've got our abductors. Last time here, make sure you have slack between your feet, seated or standing, shoulders rolled up, back and down, keeping that chest proud. And pressing out, one at a time. Good. And now our biceps. One more time. Slow and controlled right up the front, keeping that chest proud. So roll those shoulders back. Good. Pause at the top. Squeeze those biceps. Good job. Slow and controlled down. You don't want to let it just snap down, right? You want to be the boss of it. Good job. Last set should be the hardest. You should feel like it's hard to get through at the end. And rest. Just want it to have that cumulative effect. So we're going to take the band and attach it to the chair. Like so. Or whatever you have rigged up at home. And then we'll grab a sip of water and then we're going to head to our weights. Our first move, we're gonna use really light weights. So even, you know, soup cans work. We've been over like all the different weights of things we can use. We've probably all gotten really adaptable, right? So we're gonna start with our arms at 90 degrees, right? So not up here, but right here. So my hands are in front of my elbows. And then we're coming straight out to the side. Little pause. You don't want your shoulders to come up because then your neck is really gonna bother you. So just bringing everything up in line with the shoulders, but keeping the shoulders pressed down. Little pause at the top. You don't have to use weights. If this bothers your shoulder, don't do it. Very nice. Not worth it to hurt yourself. So sometimes, you know, if you're recovering from a shoulder injury, you'll just be trying to work on kind of that range of motion, and that's all you'll need to do. Totally fine. And then we're gonna take those weights, same position, but this time our palms are up. And we're just opening and closing. Working on that external rotation for our shoulders. Open and close. We've got maybe a slightly heavier weight. We have a one-armed row to a tricep extension. So it looks like this. You're gonna kneel one leg here and then your palm goes here. And you just wanna be really strong through that arm so that you're really, you know, you're not sinking down, but you're holding yourself up. We're gonna row and then a tricep extension. Good. Just like that. Keeping your core nice and tight. So your belly is pulled in, back is flat. Just keeping an eye on the floor right in front of you so that your neck isn't craning too much. And rest. Come on up, some big shoulder rolls, and then we move to the other side. And go. Straight up, and then straight back. Good. And then just squeezing, giving it a little pause right there. Keeping your abs engaged. Do two more here. And rest. Good job. Then maybe even a little heavier than that, if this one feels okay here. We've got a sumo squat with an upright row. So here are your choices. You can just turn your toes out and bring your feet wide, come straight down and up. And you don't even have to have a weight at all if you want to do just that part. Or you could just do the top half here, pulling straight up, giving a pause, or you can combine them just like that. Good. Make sure you're doing what's best for you today. You can also be seated for these. Right here, totally fine. You are the boss. Good work. And rest. Then grab your light weights again. Starting with our bent arm side raises, right here. Pausing at the top. Good job. Remember not to let those shoulders creep up to your ears. We want to keep them nice and safe. And rest. And then palms up, arms at 90, open and close. Just working on our range of motion here. One more. And rest. Then we go back to our one arm row to tricep extension. You want to make sure that you're planting your arm nice and strong, and then also really pulling that belly button in so that our core is engaged to protect our back, and then pulling straight up and then straightening that arm. That's it. You could also be here. If that position's not comfortable, just leaning forward, rowing, and extending. Some big shoulder rolls, and then we go to the other side. Send it up, pull the belly button in, and go. Rest. Then we're going to head to our sumo squat with upright row. Take your feet out nice and wide. Make sure your shoulders are rolled up, back, and down. And then coming straight down, pulling straight up. Very nice. One more, and rest. One more round of these. Grab those light weights again. Starting first, bent arm side raise, right here. Slow and controlled, little pause at the top. And rest. Now palms up, open and close. One more. And rest. Good job. Then we have our one-armed row to tricep extension. One more time per side. Nice and slow and controlled. Get ready and go. Little pause at the top. Good job. Core is nice and tight, right? Belly button's pulled in. Really strong through that supporting arm. So you don't want to sink into it and just dump the weight in that shoulder. You want to really be nice and strong and have all your muscles active in the supporting arm as well. Row and kick back. Two more. And rest. Let's do some big shoulder rolls. Then we go to the other side. Set it up. Nice, strong supporting arm, flat back, really tight core, and go. Straight up and straight back. Very nice. Really squeeze and hold. Those rhomboids between the shoulder blades is what we're working here. And then our triceps at the back of the arm. How about two more of these? And rest. Then we have one more time, sumo squats with our upright row. Grab your heavier weight. Bring those toes out nice and wide. Make sure our knees are tracking with our toes, coming down and up. So you don't want to be leaning over for these. These are your chest stays proud and just bending the legs. Very nice. Squeeze your glutes at the top. Keep your core tight. Back flat. One more. And rest. Have a seat. Grab a sip of water. Take a couple deep breaths. We're going to finish with our attached band work. So we're going to start with our chest press. And you have the option, if you would rather, to use weights. But if you use weights, you're not going to be sitting up. You'll need to be laying down and pressing up, or at least, reclined a little bit. Reason being, if you're here, it's working your shoulders. What we really want is that pushing move, pushing out. So if you don't have a chair to hook onto, you can absolutely just wrap the band around around your back and press out, or attach to, a pole or something outside. Make it work. I believe in you. We're all learning to adapt, right? Out and together. Keeping your core nice and tight. And if you look at me from the side, I'm keeping my back flat, but I lean into it. And then I press out together. So just a little bit different. It gives you a little bit more of a challenge if you're leaning out. And rest. And then we're gonna take both bands. in one hand or one band, either way. And then my elbow, I'm gonna hold with this hand, and then I press out, squeezing this tricep here. Just like that. And then switch sides. Come back to face you. Holding that elbow, pressing out, and squeezing the back of the arm. And rest. And then you take the bands over your shoulders, like so. And you're gonna cross your arms and hold the band. Don't cross the band, you will choke yourself. No. You wanna squeeze down. So I'm just really focusing on using those abdominals, pulling down, pausing at the bottom, and then slowly using those abs to come back up. Very nice. Exhale down, inhale back. And then we're gonna alternate sides. If this bothers your back, you're gonna just stick to the straight down the center. Sometimes like just going at an angle will change things in a way that doesn't feel pleasant, so we don't do it. Honestly, number one job always is doing what feels best for your body today. And every day can be different. I'll wake up and be like, what is this? And I've learned to pay attention the hard way. I start to get these little warning twinges if my back thinks about wanting to go out. And then I know, okay, rest, back off a little bit, change something so that I don't have to go through the whole rigmarole. And then pressing out here. Squeeze and hold in the middle. Couple more. Our tricep extension right here, cupping that elbow, holding it so it's nice and steady, and then pressing out, giving a good squeeze in that tricep. And the other side. Taking it over our shoulders. One more time. Crossing your arms, not the band. Exhale down. Little pause and hold at the bottom. Really put your mind in the muscle here. Feel those abs working, squeezing and holding. One more. Chest press, pressing out and together, squeezing and holding a little in the center. Good job. One more, and rest. And then we've got our tricep extension, holding that elbow, and then pressing out, squeezing the back of the arm. Good. And then the other side, right here. Two more. And rest. Then go ahead and take those bands over your shoulders. Cross your arms, hold the band. Exhale down, last time here. Really squeeze the core. One more, squeeze and hold, good, and then we will alternate. Rest. Go ahead and take that up. And now we stretch. We're going to just take one arm across our chest, right here. Give it a nice little pull. Good. And the other side. And then take your arms behind your back, pull one elbow up, and then just let your head tip over towards that elbow. And the other side. Just getting a nice stretch through your neck here. Good, and then sit up. We're going to kick one foot up and over, and then you're going to let that knee fold down. So you should feel this through your hip and glute. If that feels too much, if it's too hard to kind of get your leg up there in that position, you can straighten the bottom leg a little bit and lower it. Totally works as well. And if you don't feel like you're getting any action through that hip and glute, and you've got that good external rotation, you can lean into it and you'll feel it a little bit deeper. I definitely felt the difference. It was like, wow. And then the other side, just taking the time to set it up, and then lean in, holding the pause there, breathing into the stretch, relaxing into it. Good. And then we will come to our side. I want you to be able to see what's happening. We're going to take one leg back. What we're looking for is a stretch for the front of the hip flexor of the leg that's back. So bring it back as far as you can, and then you'll lean back into it to feel it a little deeper. But if it doesn't feel right, you can start right there. Just whatever point you start to feel the stretch. right over the front. And then lean in and twist towards the chair back, looking over your back shoulder, and then come back straight. Reach up and over. And the other side. First, finding that hip flexor stretch. Leaning back into it, if that helps. And then twisting towards the chair back, looking over that shoulder. And then come back to center, reach up and over. And rest. We're going to take one heel, set it down, pull your toes up. That outstretched leg should be nice and straight. Then sit up as tall as you can and then tip forward until you feel a stretch in the back of that hamstring. You can reach down, put your hand on your shin, or if you reach your toes, that's fine too. And the other side. And then we're going to take three. Actually, sorry, open your chest, roll your thumbs back. Reach around, grab your shoulder blades. Rock back and forth into it. I almost forgot that one. How could I? And then we will take three big deep breaths together. Inhaling up, filling your lungs, and then blow it out again. Nice deep full breath up and blow it out. One more. And blow it out. Nice work. Thank you guys so much for joining. Be sure to leave a comment if you're doing the workout, because then Silver Sneakers is actually going to be giving credit to Give Fitness. So it really helps if you can do that. All right. Even if you watch it later, you can come back and watch as many times as you want. I don't know how many times you could get credit, but worth a shot. See you later. Take care. Bye.